Solve the following inequalities. Check the answer. 7x plus 12 is greater than 40. We identify the variable term and isolate it. I will subtract 12 from both sides. So then we have 7x is greater than 28. And we will isolate the variable by dividing through by 7, yielding x is greater than 4. Now to check the solution, right, to check this answer, we first check the endpoint. So the endpoint is that value we found. So the endpoint in this case is 4. So if we substitute 4 for x, we should get an equation. We should get a true statement for equality. So is 7 times 4 plus 12 equal to 40? And 7 times 8 is 28, 7 times 4 is 28, and 28 plus 12 equals 40. So that checks out. The endpoint works. And then we check a number. In this case, since it's a greater than inequality, we'll check a number greater than 4. We want to check to see if some number greater than 4 actually is a solution of the original inequality. So I'm just going to pick a number. I'm going to say 6. Is 7 times 6 plus 12 greater than 40? Well, 7 times 6 is 42, and 42 plus 12 is 54, which is greater than 40. That checks out, and so we can be confident in our solution. All right, exercise B, we have 7x plus 15 minus 12x is greater than or equal to 75. First thing I notice is that there are like terms on the left-hand side, so let me simplify that. I have negative 5x plus 15 is greater than or equal to 75. Identify the variable term and isolate it by dividing through, subtracting 15 from both sides. So then negative 5x is greater than or equal to 60. Now, I will isolate the variable by dividing through by negative 5. But we have to be careful. When we have an inequality, if you multiply or divide both sides of an inequality, by a negative number, you must flip the symbol of inequality. So in this case, while I have isolated the x, it is now, instead of a greater than or equal to, it must be written as a less than or equal to, and 60 divided by 5 is by negative 5 is negative 12. All right, and so now let's check our answer. First equation, equality, let's check with negative 12. 7 times negative 12 plus 15 minus 12 by negative 12. Is that greater than or equal to 70? Is that equal to 75? Let's check equation first. Is that equal to 75? So negative 84 plus 15 plus 144 is, let's see, negative 84 plus 15 is negative 69, and negative 69 plus 144 is 75. Now, let's check a number less than negative 12. So how about negative 20? Is 7 times negative 20 plus 15 minus 12 by negative 20 greater than 75? Right, go back to the original inequality. Negative 140 plus 15 plus 240. Is that greater than 75? Well, negative 40 plus 15 is negative 125, plus 240 is 115, which is greater than 75, so that checks out, and I can be confident in my solution. M over 7 plus 18 is less than 6. All right, I can isolate the variable term, and by subtracting 18, so I'd have m over 7 is less than negative 12. Now, to isolate the variable, I would multiply through by 7. Now, notice I'm multiplying through by a positive number. Right? I'm multiplying both sides by 7, a positive number. I do not need to flip the symbol of inequality. And so then m is less than negative 84. Let's run our check. Is negative 84 over 7 plus 18 equal to 6? Well, negative 84 divided by 7, that's negative 12, and negative 12 plus 18 is equal to 6, so that checks out. And now let's try a number less than negative 84, and so just to make the numbers nice, how about negative 140? Is negative 140 over 7 plus 18 less than 6? Negative 140 over 7 is negative 20, and negative 20 plus 18 is negative 2, which is less than 6, and that checks out. I can be confident in my solution. And exercise D, 8 times p plus 4 is less than or equal to 12p minus 36. Apply the distributive property. 8p plus 32 is less than or equal to 12p minus 36. Let's get all of the variable terms to one side of the equation. I'll do that by subtracting 12p from both sides, yielding negative 4p plus 32 is less than or equal to negative 36. I will isolate the variable term by subtracting 32 from both sides. So then negative 4p is less than or equal to negative 68. And then I'll divide through by negative 4 to isolate the variable. Notice again, I'm dividing through by a negative number, so I flip the symbol of inequality to a greater than or equal to, and I have p is greater than or equal to positive 17. Let's check our work. Is 8 times 17 plus 4 equal to 12 times 17 minus 36. All right, the left-hand side, that's 8 times 21, which is 168. On the right-hand side, 12 times 17 is 204, and 204 minus 36 is 168, so that checks out. And now, checking a number greater than 17, how about 20? Is 8 times 20 plus 4 less than or equal to 12 times 20 minus 36? So 8 times 24 is 192. Is that less than 240 minus 36, which is 240 minus 36 is 204, and that is certainly less than, so that checks out. And so we can be confident in our solution.